were to stay a restaurant for the first ever photo tour, photo contest of Philadelphia's Greek community. And I'm with the chair, Georgia Clutches. Georgia, thanks for having us out. Tell us about the show.
Thank you very much, Cosmos Philly, for coming this evening. We're excited that you're here. We're excited about the event. It was really an event that we thought about over a cup of coffee with a few friends and thought, what a great opportunity to bring people together from all organizations and churches and societies to tell a story. And what's a better way to tell a story than through pictures? And these pictures, if you go around, you'll see some of the pictures are from 1920, others are from 1950, 1963, and so forth and so on. And this is the story of Philadelphia. The story is so vast. Our legacy is so amazing that it's just an exciting event. And we just started it, and we're going to continue it and grow it bigger. And I encourage the community to hold your pictures, reach out to our organization, submit the pictures, donate the pictures, and this is how our story will be told. It's our story. It's our history, our father's story, our grandfather's story, our great-grandfather's story, and it needs to be told through our eyes, and it's just an amazing night. We're very excited.
In summary, when you were taping the two Christuses, were one picture of the naval officers dancing at Penn's Landing, and the individual pulls out another picture of the naval officers roasting at the Navy Yard, just created that goosebump that you're always looking for, that always gives me that emotion to keep on going for many, many years to come to preserve and promote Hellenism in this area.
This is a picture of my father, Chris Katsakis, down at the Philadelphia Naval Yard in 1973. It was when the submarine was being escorted. And you show him here, he was working in the duty-free industry, and he knew all the ship members, and our family was invited down. I remember this distinctly. I was almost about 3 years old, and I noticed this larger picture behind me of the same event, and now we are looking at combining this into a larger collage of imagery, because I've never met this gentleman before, but was it your cousin?
Yeah. Now the history continues. My name is Chris. His name is Chris. Christakis, Kotsakis. We just met.
We never
knew each other. This is a picture that was taken in 1973 by my wife, future wife, my girlfriend at the time. This guy is my cousin. He's a medical doctor, an officer in the Greek Navy. They came from Greece to receive a reconditioned submarine. And it happened to be Easter time. And they invited us to go down and have Easter. And they, down the line, they were cooking lambs. And this guy's got up and started dancing. It was, you know, it was just a great, some of the Americans were looking at them saying, what is going on? But this brings up a lot of memories. Very nice
Fantastic.
To meet you.
Chris. Pleasure to meet you.
Very good.
I was 3 years old at the time, but now I'm 44 and we finally meet. I was probably there as a little
right.
child, and he was much younger. But it's very interesting to connect these two events together.
I think it's fantastic. It's a different event. It's not something that's been tried before. There's some really nice photos that really haven't been displayed before, and it gets you emotional to even see. So I really like it, and I'm glad it ended up being a good turnout.
All in all, with the exhibit so far, there's a blast from the past, from every decade that I haven't been around for. So one in particular that I liked most and I heard a story about was Harry Karapolitis in his former band. So he used to be a keyboard player. That was kind of cool to learn about.
I think this is so wonderful to be able to look back and see a lot of our parents, our grandparents, myself when I was in Greek school. So it's really, really neat. I love the concept. It's just a wonderful thing that they're doing. It's a lot of work, but what doesn't take work to have a nice outcome? So I'm enjoying it very much.
Hi, my name is Chris Katsakis, and I'm here today at the event, and I've submitted this picture. What we're seeing here is my father, who was a first lieutenant on the USS, was formerly the USS Ludlow. It was a ship that was mothballed by the U.S. fleet during World War II and sold to Greece. He had already been an officer in the 2 years and was renamed the Doxa after the original Doxa destroyer. He's receiving an award from King Paul of Greece himself for exemplary service.
Where did this picture take place?
That was in Greece on the deck of the Doxa before launch here to the United States in Philadelphia. They were coming here in 53 to escort two more destroyers that Greece bought that were mothballed by the U.S. fleet because Greece had lost most of their ships during World War II, so they bought them and purchased them, and they were escorting them back, and that's how he met my mother here in Philadelphia.
My name is Helen Shryko. It's Helen Cozzanitas Shryko.
Tell us about the photograph. When was it taken?
It was taken, I believe, maybe 1940.
Where?
Not sure. In Kennett Square, Pennsylvania, where it was a restaurant with homemade candy, homemade ice cream, and, you know.
Was it a family business?
It was a family business. My father owned the business.
So that's where you grew up? Your family was in Kennett Square?
Yes. I grew up in Kennett Square, went to Kennett Square High School.
Did your father have any Greek food in the restaurant, or was it classic American diner?
It was classic American.
Did you work in the store?
Yes. And it was homemade candies. I helped them to sell the candies, and I helped. It was homemade ice cream. I also helped make the ice cream.
Now, ladies, there's a photograph behind you that we want to feature. I'd like you each to tell me something about the photograph. You're all in it. Why don't you start?
Okay, this was a production that was done every year, maybe 3 or 4 years, but we were in this one. It was around 1953, and the son of Papa Mukidi was a graduate of Yale. He was a thespian, and he put on this production from ancient Greece to ballerinas to Koroto Zolongu, and it was quite a big affair, and it was always because the church name day was Evangelismos, and we belonged to that church.
So
the Ben Franklin Hotel.
Yeah. Tell us about that moment. Can you remember something about that day or that production?
Well, it was rather tense, trying to get ready and make sure everything was perfect. And it was great. We had many, many rehearsals. I remember having a lot of fun through the rehearsals and the performance. And it was just a great time in my life.
First, tell us your name.
Peter Kletches.
There's a photograph behind me that looks like you're in there. Talk about the photograph and what's happening and what year it was.
It was probably in the early 70s. It's when we were all being awarded our Eagle Scout badges. It was the first time ever that there were 9 Eagle Scouts all at one time. I think it was definitely first in Pennsylvania, and I might have been first in the United States that there were 9 people that were all got it all at the same time.
And it was taken where?
I believe that one was taken at St. Demetrius Church in Upper Darby, where we had our meetings.
And a little bit of information about that particular Boy Scout troop.
That was, we call that the Greek troop. That was the St. D's troop that in my day was headed up by Teddy Mangus. And there were 2 or 3 scoutmasters before him, from what I understand. So I would have probably been 1970 or 1968 when I joined the troop, and probably lasted until the mid-70s in the troop. And the funny thing is that every one of those fellas in that picture are still friends of mine today.
This is People's Choice Award, and it's worth its weight in gold. Because those two, he's talking, he says, I recognize this picture. I say, whose is it? I point Christa out, and the conversation happened.
It brings up a lot of memories, but meeting this gentleman here, another Chris, who was there with his dad, taking another picture the same day, it meant a lot. It was, it gave us goosebumps.
And luckily, my mother always wrote on back of the photos.
God bless him.
And my father said, Lenny, what are you doing? She goes, one day the children need to know. Well, today it worked out.
What a great way to finish. Bravo, Kanyev, Aristotle. Thank you for sharing your stories. This is what it's all about. This is the goosebumps that you guys are making fun of me all the time. This is what goosebumps is all about. Thank you again. You're here for Zohar Police Drive Safety. And thank you for finding the traffic and coming in tonight.